KUAM TV, 65 years of firsts on Guam.
KUAM News Headlines is presented by Calvo's Insurance, a legacy of trust, serving Micronesia since 1938. Matson, celebrating 25 years of commitment to Guam, Micronesia, and the CNMI. Cars Plus Hyundai, home of the Kona electric vehicle, an electric heart with an SUV soul. Test drive yours today at Cars Plus. McDonald's of Guam, I'm loving it, and King's Restaurant, serving your local breakfast, lunch, and dinner favorites for over 45 years.
Ahead on Primetime, a man is arrested after a stabbing incident at a Tumuning apartment leaves one person dead. Hannah Devonzo has the story. Plus, children 5 to 11 years old can start getting vaccinations starting tomorrow. And ancient burials have been uncovered in the North Finnegayan area. These stories and more on Primetime.
Half a day and a good evening. 27-year-old Akmal Koziev was arrested in connection to a stabbing incident that led to the death of Dr. Miran Rabadi on Sunday afternoon at the Ponciana Apartments in Tumuning, where Koziev lived. KUAM's Hannah Devonzo has more.
Koziev allegedly stabbed Rabadi and killed him at an apartment complex in Tumuning on Sunday. According to JJ and Francesca Ambrose, owners and trainers at Steel Athletics claim they knew Koziev well and describe him to be like family.
The man that we knew was so loving, so caring, loved kids, loved our kids. I mean, he helped my daughter numerous times.
He would follow her around the gym and let her do pretty much whatever she wanted.
Yeah, he genuinely cared so much about the people in this gym and their well-being.
And he loved his family.
Yeah. He loved his family. I mean, he kissed his mother's feet. I mean,
literally.
Just, he was such a great person up until he wasn't.
Koziev was a trainer at Steel Athletics for years and was let go months ago for threatening customers. The couple noticed that he was dangerous and tried warning people, including the police. It felt as if nobody took them seriously.
We did everything we possibly could to warn people that AK wasn't AK anymore.
He was not the guy that everyone knew from around the gym anymore.
It's very hard. I mean, I know, because when you're friends with two people and those two people are on the outs, you don't want to take sides. You just kind of want to ride in the middle. But in this case, AK seriously needed help. And I think that that was the problem, that people were trying to not take sides. And he seriously needed help this whole time.
The couple slowly distanced themselves from Koziev, but the victim, Dr. Rabadi, who was a member at Steel Athletics for the last 4 years, allegedly remained close to Koziev.
Miran was the one guy that was supporting him. You know, he was such a great person. You know, he was a doctor and he was always in the gym working out and taking care of his health and fitness. He was one of those doctors that leads from the front. So to hear about him being the victim, it's such a shocker, you know.
It makes no sense.
Zero sense, because he was the one who was supporting AK, you know, even after he left the gym.
Ambrose alleged that he was threatened by Koziev through a video just days before. He was arrested for aggravated murder, aggravated assault, use of a deadly weapon in the commission of a felony, strangulation, felonious restraint, assault, and family violence. He was booked and confined. Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Hannah Devonzo.
Late this afternoon, the Guam Police Department issued a press release, and based on their investigation, the victim, 44-year-old Dr. Miran Rabadi, went to visit Akmal Koziev at his residence at the apartments. The two went into Koziev's room and an argument ensued. Dr. Rabadi tried to leave, but according to the release, Koziev allegedly stopped him and began to choke and stab the doctor with a foreign object. The suspect's family then reportedly tried to stop him, but they were assaulted as well. When the family ran out of the apartment, the suspect allegedly again attacked the victim. Koziev, as reported, was arrested for aggravated murder. It started in Saipan this past Saturday, and here on Guam, children ages 5 to 11 will be able to get vaccinated starting tomorrow. Daniel Perez has more.
According to public health spokesperson Janella Carrera, all 7,500 doses of the Pfizer pediatric vaccine are now on island.
Our plan now, which we are mobilizing our team, is to begin offering pediatric COVID-19 doses, vaccinations starting tomorrow. We are planning to open up our northern community, northern region community health center, as well as our southern region community health center from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. so that we can offer COVID-19 vaccinations to children ages 5 to 11. We will be sending out a link, an Eventbrite link, so that parents and guardians can schedule their appointments online and, you know, reserve that spot. But we will, of course, welcome walk-ins as well on a limited basis.
In order for children to get the vaccine, all minors must be accompanied by a parent or a legal guardian and provide government-issued identification to validate age. The minor's birth certificate is also acceptable. Parent or legal guardian must have a government-issued ID, and guardians must also present legal guardianship or power of attorney documentation. Meanwhile, according to the CDC, children ages 5 through 11 years receive an age-appropriate dose that is one-third of the adult dose of Pfizer vaccine. Smaller needles, designed specifically for children, are also used for this specific age group. The CDC also reports possible side effects include pain on the arm your child received the shot, including redness and swelling. Your child might also experience tiredness, headache, muscle pain, chills, pain, or nausea. The side effects should go away in a few days. Carrera adds public health is working with the island's school system to offer more opportunities for children to get the shot.
Tomorrow will not be the only opportunity for parents and students and children to be able to get their vaccines if they're within that age group. Of course, we will be scheduling and announcing the availability of these vaccines for future dates, even prior to November 20th, which would be the date that we're eyeing, which I just want to say it's not official, but we're eyeing for the first school-based immunization in partnership with GDOE and other schools.
Daniel Perez reporting for Guam's News Network.
Daniel adds that the Guam Guard will also be administering the pediatric vaccine at the UOG Calvo Fieldhouse tomorrow from 3 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. and then on Wednesday from 2 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. Walk-ins are welcomed, but appointments will be prioritized. To schedule your child's appointment, go to tinyurl.com/COVID-stops-with-me. Shifting to news from the CNMI, an essential worker from Guam who did not follow protocol likely caused a spike in COVID-19 community cases on Saipan. The news comes as kids in the NMI roll up their sleeves for vaccination. Tomas Mengloña has the details.
A non-compliant essential worker from Guam is linked to the recent spike in community cases on Saipan.
They're supposed to just go to work, go home or go to their lodging. What we found out from this essential worker was that they were actually thinking of attending a party. And so we did, you know, bring them back to Canoa, and basically said that, you know, you're done. you got to go back. But, and decided to leave right away. So, again, you know, I cannot. The only thing I can say is that I cannot confirm, of course, because we still need to know if that was the individual, but we can confirm that the contacts were somehow connected with this individual.
It's unclear if any legal action will be taken. She says the focus remains on saving lives.
What we are looking at for the next step really is, basically strengthen our testing strategies also working with the contact tracing. The contact tracing is excellent. They do excellent work. And with the lab and our nurses here, really working really, really hard.
And with schools set to reopen in the coming days, vaccine mandates also loom.
Our Board of Trustees did approve the adding the COVID vaccines into the current law. The current law does require that students, if they're going to be attending school, they have to have a health certificate, and that requires that they get the vaccines that are, you know, from measles, mumps, rubella, everything. We just added the COVID-19 vaccines into that.
She says the vast majority of comments they've received so far are in favor of the requirement, but has this message to those who are still hesitant.
These are safe. The vaccines are safe. They were not rushed. they were all tested, and you know, there's data. Obviously, even FDA has given a unanimous approval. Let me just go back to that. FDA unanimously approved for the panel, approved the vaccine for children. So did the ACIP committee, you know, the Advisory Council for Immunization Practices. They also unanimously approved these vaccines. So I have no reason to doubt that. This is a Chamorro traditional way of protecting your loved ones. You know, so yeah, it is your choice, but you have to understand that, you know, it's also some people don't have a choice and it's unfair to them, you know, and I feel like we need to be able to protect others.
So far, over 100 children received the first dose of the Pfizer vaccine on Saipan. The vaccine for kids was made available to families on Rota and Tinian on Monday. Tomas Manglotnya for KUAM News.
You can view the full interview with hospital CEO Esther Munya on our YouTube channel. The clock is ticking on the new federal mandate for local businesses with more than 100 employees to come up with a vaccination plan. They have until January 1st to implement it. Attorney Michael Pangolinan of the Society for Human Resources Management Organization says the Biden administration was innovative in tapping the Occupational Safety and Health Administration as a regulatory agency. He says the vaccine mandate will be implemented as part of a new OSHA standard.
And so it's the unvaccinated employees that they believe are the employees that need to be protected and that are in grave danger. And the way that OSHA has determined to address that, the best way is through vaccination.
So for employees, it's either be vaccinated or undergo weekly COVID testing. There are exceptions, though. For example, employees who work remotely are not required to submit to weekly testing. Pangolinan says most local hotels would be impacted by the new law. He says they should be very familiar with compliance with OSHA standards. Congress passed the president's $1.2 trillion bipartisan infrastructure bill over the weekend. Congressman Michael Sinicola says the measure contains an increase in highway funds from $17 million to $45 million, funding to expand broadband access for families, as well as funding to address water infrastructure. The bill is before President Biden, who is expected to sign it. Meanwhile, the Build Back Better bill is still being debated. This measure also contains millions for Guam, including $345 million to build a new hospital, and a provision the congressman has been working on for the inclusion of Guam and other U.S. territories in the Supplemental Security Income, or SSI, program. Governor Lulian Guerrero and members of her fiscal team leave Wednesday for New York City, where they'll be meeting with ratings agencies. Communications Director Crystal Paco San Agustin said in a statement that the governor would only borrow to build or to make debt cheaper. She adhered to this philosophy while concurrently holding the line on expenses while pushing out federal stimulus monies. The release states that the governor will be working to provide ratings agencies with a total picture of the overall fiscal health of the island and, quote, pave the way for an upward movement in ratings, which can result in favorable pricing and low interest rates. While the rest of the country reopens its borders to international travelers tomorrow, today a new White House directive and CDC rule went into effect on Guam. It is now a requirement for all non-U.S. citizens, non-immigrant passengers from a foreign country to show proof of being fully vaccinated before entering the United States. In addition to proof of vaccination, the White House says tourists will be required to take a pre-departure COVID-19 test within 3 days of their flight and show proof of a negative result before boarding. Another negative test result will be required 3 to 5 days after arrival. Once again, we invite you to voice your view across our social media pages with our daily question. Today we ask, did you experience any side effects after any of the COVID-19 vaccine doses? We'll share the responses on the link tomorrow morning. Stay tuned. We're back with more news after the break.
Taco Bell is so good and so cheap.
I know, right? I wonder why.
What if they know we're broke? What if they're trying to be the good guys?
Yeah. Thanks, Taco Bell!
Don't need to worry. work, but keep the smile on your face. The moments you can't replace, and I'll be around.
Wherever life takes you, we're always here for you. Calvo's Insurance. Count on us for life.
It's a special delivery to your inbox every week with your KUAM News Roundup, program advisories, and promotions. Sign up for the weekly KUAM Digital Digest today on KUAM.com.
Owasaina, owasaina, fauna dan puntan ipumatina.
And that was video courtesy of the State Historic Preservation Office. Local historian Tony Ramirez performing a chant at a newly found additional burials at Marine Corps Base Camp Bloss. They were recently reported to the State Historic Preservation Office by the U.S. Navy. The new burials account for an estimated 15 individuals found in the area. There have been a total of 9 burials found in some 26 separate areas on base grounds where human remains, including bone fragments, have been found. According to the SHPO Patrick Lujan, this most recent discovery is located within and directly adjacent to an area already marked off to protect previously uncovered remains and confirms that it was an important place of ancient burial. Work is underway to build a monument at the 1,100 square meter site, which has been designated as an area for preservation in place where remains will not be disinterred. They were found by archaeologists during prep work for that memorial. The commander of the U.S. 7th Fleet, Vice Admiral Carl Thomas, relieved top commanding officers of the USS Connecticut of their duties. The action follows an investigation that determined the submarine ran into an uncharted seamount last month while operating in international waters in the Indo-Pacific region. Vice Admiral Thomas cited a loss of confidence and determined sound judgment, prudent decision-making, and adherence to required procedures in navigation planning, watch team execution, and risk management could have prevented the incident. The USS Connecticut remains in Guam while undergoing damage assessment and will return to Bremerton, Washington for repairs. Expect the arrival this week of a large U.S. Navy vessel and several thousand sailors for a port call. The Chamber of Commerce was notified that the visiting military personnel will be granted shore leave during their visit. Meanwhile, the Navy has not yet confirmed any details. A spokesperson for Joint Region Mariana said that due to operational security, she would not be able to release any information about port calls until 24 hours of arrival. Separately, she said Pacific Command would be issuing a news release about Taiwanese troops that may be conducting training in Guam. The matter has geopolitical implications as China remains sensitive to any training by the Taiwan military on foreign soil. Beijing views Taiwan as a renegade province of China. The Department of Parks and Recreation's deputy director has tendered his resignation. His last day on the job was last Friday. No word yet on his replacement. DPR Director Roque Alcantara confirmed Victor Villagomez is relocating to the mainland. A brilliant painting adorns the walls of the UOG's Calvo Fieldhouse, bringing a new point of interest to the university. The University of Guam unveiled a mural for its 70th anniversary, celebrating 7 decades of transforming lives and advancing communities. UOG Chief Marketing and Communications Officer Jonas Macapinlac said during the unveiling ceremony, the project first began 2 years ago in November 2019, but due to the COVID pandemic, it was put to a halt. Fast forward to today, the beautiful, unique, Instagram-worthy mural was released to the public, which was done by UOG alumnus Austin Domingo.
It's filled with motifs that embody the steadfast spirit of the university and the island. The U displays the trident of Triton, the university mascot, and a kolo, chamorro for trumpet shell, with elements of the UOG seal inside. The O depicts a sea turtle, which represents wisdom, perseverance, and guidance, decorated with imagery prominent in Guam, including the sun, alade stone leaves, woven patterns, and bougainvillea. The G portrays a carabao with a mermaid body, an interpretation of the seahorses that pull the mythical sea god Poseidon's chariot. It tells the tell forms official paying homage to the university's Big G logo.
Domingo majored in fine arts and graduated from UOG in 2012. It took about a month to complete the culturally pride-infused art piece. Stay tuned. Up next, Dave Delgado is up next with sports.
Your community calendar is brought to you by Taco Bell. Whether it's your first meal or your fourth meal, we've got you covered. Taco Bell, live mas.
From now until December 31, enter to win the 1 million Pacific Points giveaway. Simply activate your account, refer friends, earn and redeem points at Foodies, Shell, and ITE. Learn more about the 1 million Pacific Points giveaway at PacificPoints.com. Pacific Points. Do more, get more.
Guam's auto appearance specialist, Elegant Reflections, has been providing the automotive industry with professional detailing and car care products at its highest quality, from complete detailing, full interior detailing, exterior detailing, headlamp restoration, hand washing, seat and carpet shampoo, engine degreasing, undercarriage cleaning, paint sealant, fabric protection, paint oxidation removal, and so much more. Visit us at our new location. Call 646-5555 for an appointment. Elegant Reflections, Guam's auto appearance specialist, over 20 years of experience.
Yaman, reintroducing the Tumon Pans with plenty rice. Every day of the week, Tumon Jamaican Grill has a special for you for $20. Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays features jerk chicken and ribs. Thursdays, the sweet and tangy Jamango barbecue ribs. Friday, check out what we caught for you in our fried local catch. And finally, our weekend family platter is only $50. That's $9 off. Yaman, Tumon Pans. Call to order 647-3000 or 4000. Yaman, Jamaican.
Yaman, serious food.
There will come a time when people talk about how Hyundai makes the best car on the road. Now seems about right. The technologically advanced Hyundai Elantra is the 2021 North American Car of the Year.
KUAM Sports is brought to you by Docomo Pacific. Better together.
GW at home against the FD Friars. Tough run by Austin Uggan. Picking up the first down on the play. Tackle made by Caleb Murphy. Gecko's linebacker, Jonas Gumabon, makes the play. Coming up with a nice stop. Freshman phenom Tristan Burgos blows through the line and makes the tackle at the line of scrimmage for FD. Kyle Gogui followed his fullback left and bounced it to the outside for the long touchdown run. Gogui in full stride, breaking away from the defense for the game's first score. The touchdown setup kicker David Leon Guerrero for the PAT. 7-0 Friars after the successful attempt. Hayden Sellis with the deep drop back finds wide receiver Robert Raras on the screenplay. Raras picks up a few good blocks. Fourth and goal, Geckos pull a play out of their book and go fake run halfback pass to a wide open Noah Castro for the score. 7-7 tie after the point after kick. Gotta show some love for the GW secondary. Number 7, Jaden Santos breaks up the play. Santos pumped up. Zach Munoz was like, yo, let's run that back. Munoz splits the defense and makes the reception for the first down. Kyle Gogui goes in for the short touchdown run. 13-7, Friars retake the lead. Caleb Murphy coming up big for FD. Pick 6, put the Friars up 19-7. Murphy slides left and makes the break on the ball and takes it to the house. Laven Santos also recorded an interception. Santos, right place at the right time, gets rewarded for his effort. Alex Sojo with the RPO picks up a nice little gain with the keeper. That set up Kyle Gogwe for his third rushing touchdown of the game. Gogwe confirming his touchdown. Friars went on to win and stay undefeated in the ESA Football League. Make sure to check out tomorrow night's College Combine and clinic hosted by 671 Recruiting being held at Guam High. The gate will open at 5 p.m. The event is for athletes grades 7 through 12. All participants must have an up-to-date physical and proof of vaccination. Those attending the combine will be timed in the 40-yard dash, L drill, shuttle run, vertical, and more. Bring a water bottle and make sure to wear your mask. For more info, contact Coach Jacob Dowdell at 671-487-1749.
KUAM Sports is brought to you by Docomo Pacific. Better together.
You are everything that matters to me, and I promise to do whatever it takes to keep you healthy, to be comfortable, and to be free. I love you. As long as we're together, I'll always make sure that home will always be our best place to breathe.
At the Vocal Box, we understand that everyone is different, which is why our meal plans are designed to fit different lifestyles. Whether you need easy and convenient meals because you're on the front lines, breaking personal records, or just trying to live a healthier lifestyle, we have a meal plan for you. Our meals are made with the most fresh, all-natural ingredients that are always grain, gluten, and refined sugar-free. Spend less time cooking and more time living. Call us at 922-BOCA, visit our website, or stop by our cafe in Hagatnya to start your meal subscription today. The Boca Box, real nutrition made daily.
Welcome back, everybody. We continue with our weekly segment highlighting some of the island's businesses who are Guam Safe certified by GVB and have the World Travel and Tourism Council's Safe Travel stamp. Tonight, we feature Tango Theaters at the Micronesia Mall.
Guam Safe and WTTC Safe Travel Certified Program Showcase is brought to you in partnership with the Guam Visitors Bureau.
Hi, my name is Constance, and I'm the marketing manager here at Tango Theaters. So Tango Theaters thought it was important to get the Guam Safe Certified seal just to have our community know that we are keeping them in mind when they come visit and watch movies at our location. You know, it's a different experience from dining in. You're actually in the comfort of our auditorium, watching the movie on the big screen. So we all want to make sure that everyone is safe in the auditorium, out in the auditorium, our staff, and even the community, just so that, you know, the trust is being built again to come back and be able to have this family time at our location. What it means to have the stamp is that Tango Theaters is up to par with all the regulations that comes with making sure that your visit here is safe. We have sanitizers at every location in the lobby, at our registers, even as you enter. We did implement assigned seating, so when you do come into the auditorium, you know that you are spaced out from other groups. And it's not only to the community that we want to know that we are certified, also the visitors coming to Guam, because, you know, Tango Theaters, we do have foreign films. We have the Japanese anime, Korean concert films, and also the Filipino titles. So steps that we've taken to ensure that it is safe to come watch at Tango Theaters: our staff is 100% vaccinated, masks are worn at all times, even if we're in the box office behind a glass, our team is wearing masks. We also have implemented assigned seating, so when customers do buy their tickets, they know that they're being separated from other groups in the auditorium. They have their safe bubble while watching a movie, and our team is going in and out an auditorium in between showtimes just to ensure that those who aren't actively drinking and eating are wearing their masks. Sanitizers can be found anywhere in the lobby, at our registers, and even when you walk in. And before and after each movie, our team goes in, sanitizes each and every seat, every railing, just so that the next showtime is prepped for the next guest.
Guam Safe and WTTC Safe Travel Certified Program Showcase is brought to you in partnership with the Guam Visitors Bureau.
We're at the end of our show, and you know what that means, birthday shoutouts.
We want to send a special happy birthday wish to all of our November 8th babies, including Anaya LeVay Torres Flores, who celebrates birthday, fittingly, number 8 today. Happy birthday to you, and we love you and hope you enjoy your special day. Lots of love from Amaya, Jacob, Ariana, Gabriel, Mommy, Daddy, and of course, Papa, Auntie Jennifer, and the rest of the family. Celebrating birthday 9 today, and that's a lot of candles to blow out. Joseph Borja, and to our Sunshine, S-O-N, Sunshine, our handsome Joseph, we love you and hope you enjoyed your birthday from Mom, Dad, and the family. Chelsea Babalta celebrates birthday number 12, and happy birthday to you, Chessie Jaylene Regis Babalta. This is coming from your Dion, Noah, Wyatt, Renesmee, and your Regis and Babalta families. Rollin S. Kanata, happy birthday to bro and uncle, and quite simply, we hope you had an awesome day. And Fred Fernandez, to the best husband, dad, and papa, we pray your day is as special and wonderful as you are. You deserve the world. We love you so much. And belated birthday wishes going out to Serenity Sablon Diego, who was born on the 6th. Happy blessed birthday, Rena. May the Lord bless you on another birthday. Enjoy your special day. Love and hugs from the whole family. And Francis Cabana, who was born on the 7th. Biba cumpleaños, Francis. From your man, Rudy, Rudena, Peter, Paul David, Hannah, Vera Mindy, Patty, and the entire family.
Thanks, Jason. Stay tuned up next, Pacific Matters with Tomas Manglonia. We'll see you tomorrow for The Link.
Welcome to another episode of Pacific.